grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mary, Queen, Beauty of Carmel, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Thou hast visited the earth and inebriated it. Thou hast wonderfully enriched it. These words of the psalmist, the Church applies to the visitation of the Blessed Virgin Mary, upon which we meditated a little bit just this past Sunday, the second joyful mystery. Today we commemorate that which is a very sweet and a very gracious visitation of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we might say to us in a particular way, in this sense, that our Blessed Mother visited the land which was once her fair dowry. In the 13th century, she appeared at Aylesford in Kent in England to the first Western English Master General of the Carmelite Order. And the purpose of Our Lady's visit to England and to this particular Carmelite friar was to encourage and to strengthen the Carmelites so that they could exist, because there were many who wanted them to be abolished, and not only that they should exist, but that they should be the source of a constant blessing of Our Blessed Mother to all of us, that she would visit us with her protection on earth, and even after the time of our death, that she would come and visit us in purgatory. The Carmelite order had begun in the Holy Land, of course, and its origins go back to the prophet Elias and Eliseus in the Old Testament, and they were the very first at Pentecost to honor Our Blessed Mother, to build a chapel to her glory. But when the time came for the whole of the Middle East, and Palestine in particular, finally to be abandoned to the power of the Muslims, and thus to be terribly chastised, why then the order was translated from the west, from the east to the west. But because they were a new order and unfamiliar to people, and because of the unusual habit that these friars wore, they were called the Striped Brethren, because their habit had a series of stripes. It was a rather dramatic and outrageous affair to the eyes of the civilized Europeans. And these things made everyone to be prejudiced against the Carmelites. And so there were many voices raised. The Carmelites should be suppressed, abolished. But Our Blessed Lady appeared to Simon Stock, who was humbly sleeping in his tree trunk, as was his wont. He was very much in the medical spirit of the early friars of Mount Carmel. He was a hermit, really, at heart still, as they were in the Holy Land on Mount Carmel itself. And Our Lady gave him that part of the habit that had been the peculiarity and the privilege only of the Benedictines, that is to say, the scapular, not the little scapular that you and I wear so faithfully, but I mean the long, kind of an apron, all the way down the front and over the shoulders, all the way down the back. And this apron or scapular worn from the shoulders, but the Latin word for shoulders, scapula, is therefore the sign of Our Blessed Mother's protection. And Our Lady gave a promise with the scapular to, first of all, to the Carmelite order, which later on in time would be spread slowly to the laity who would be associated in a confraternity of the Carmelites. Whoever dies clothed in this scapular will not suffer eternal fire. What a beautiful and a wondrous promise of Our Blessed Mother. So Our Lady at the same time gives encouragement and protection to what is really her original order in the Church, and at the same time, in due time, this encouragement, this protection of eternal salvation, that we will not perish eternally if we do our part as faithful members of the scapular confraternity, comes then to the whole Catholic Church. And then the last visitation, you might say, aside from the visitation that we hope to receive on the first Saturday after our death and the fires of purgatory, should it needs be, the last visitation is one of those wonderful visions at Fatima, where a Blessed Lady is clothed in the Carmelite habit. And thus Our Lady gives her blessing in a particular way and associates the message of Fatima and the devotion to the Immaculate Heart with the Carmelite order and the confraternity of the scapular. So many beautiful promises, so many glorious visits that are made. Delightful visitation these. Truly, Our Lady is always visiting the earth, and she's always enriching it. Let us thank Our Lady for all of the graces that she gives to us. And sometimes when we kiss our scapular and pray our morning offering, let us be conscious of that wonderful thought that by means of this scapular, many, many souls are meant to be saved from eternal damnation, from perishing eternally. Just as once Our Lady came down to this earth and protected her special order from perishing, so will she preserve all of those who are honorary members of her order. Only they will do their part. Only they will observe their promises, chastity according to their state of life, and the rosary, the five decades of it at least recited each day. Well, Our Lady surely will do hers. The time of the visitation of the Blessed Mother is not yet ordered, not yet over. The order of Mount Carmel and the whole story of the scapular feast is a beautiful illustration of the truth of the psalmist. Thou hast visited the earth, and thou hast inebriated it. Thou hast wonderfully enriched it. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.